can't put the gay genie back in the bottle. There's no way we're going to undo the rights that we've achieved. We're only going to keep marching forward.
Marching alongside thousands of others in the Pride Parade, Jimmy Flanagan, the first openly gay Austin City Council member, celebrates the progress of rights for the LGBTQ community. While the parade is a moment for celebration, Flanagan says they still have a long ways to go.
Let's not forget, there are still rights that we're fighting for. We cannot be open in our employment. We're still struggling to be open in our military.
A major setback for the LGBTQ community happened back in July when President Trump announced on Twitter transgender people would be banned from the U.S. military.
It's really the ongoing struggle. Every time you take two steps forward, like with marriage equality in 2015, you're going to have to take one step back and keep fighting. And that's what we're doing.
But those at the parade say it's important to show support and make sure LGBTQ rights don't go backwards.
We as adults that can vote need to go and just support them and be activists for them.
It's important that we stand strong regardless of the leadership of the country right now. It's important that we show who we are and who we're going to become no matter who's in charge right now.
Just this week, the nation's top military officer, General Joseph Dunford, said he supported transgender troops and anyone who meets the military's demanding standards should be allowed to continue to serve.
But if you do good at your job, you deserve to have that job. It does not matter any of your demographics, LGBT, gender, race, and transgender members of the military serve with distinction and honor. The generals know it, the community knows it, the military knows it. It's just time for President Trump to know it.